Yeah, people have heard of it.
They don't even have a zip code. Yeah, what's the name of it?
It's close to everything. People are flocking to it from all over.
What's the name of it?
Beaumont.
Beaumont? Where the hell is Beaumont?
You're playing so cool. Obey in every rule. Stay right down in your heart. You're burning out in the sun. Somebody to tell you that life ain't passing you by. Ain't passing me by. Somebody to tell you. It will if you don't even try. You're lost.
If you'd only come around.
Cut, cut, loose. Whoa.
I can't close the trunk, the backseat is full.
Fran, don't start. I don't want to move any more than you do.
Yeah, right.
Look, I too wish your father hadn't left. I too wish things could be the way they were.
Okay, okay.
And we both wish I could be one of those strong single moms who suddenly become self-sufficient. But I'm not. Please feel free to disagree.
We've got a 10-hour drive. I'm sure I'll think of something.
First you got to turn it around, then put your feet on the ground. Now take the whole of your soul. Ah, life keeps holding me down. Everybody cut.
Someday, Lord, I pray, tell me exactly the words to say. Give me strength, and maybe then I can reach my fellow men, so we all may rise again. Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, Reverend.
I took the long way to church this morning, down by Jack Halliby's Creek. I heard birds chirping and the sound of our own choir warming up in the distance. I was reminded of a line by our great poet, Walt Whitman, who wrote, "I hear America singing." And I thought, well, aren't we the song that we sing? Don't we raise our voices to tell the world who we are and what we believe? So I ask you all this morning, what song are you singing?
We've only been here 2 days and already Chicago seems a million miles away. But we were barely hanging on, especially with my father gone. There's not too many places we could stay. What's meaningful to find a job that's steady? And maybe I can stand it for a year. And maybe things won't be so bad. And maybe I won't miss my dad. And maybe we can start a new life here.
Start a new life here.
But if Walt Whitman were alive today, what song would he hear America singing? When I turn on the television, I hear the music of easy sexuality and relaxed morals. I hear rock and roll and the endless chant of pornography. And I ask myself, why does our God allow this? We all know he has the power to take those books, records, videos, and turn them into one big fiery cinder like that. But he doesn't. Why? Because God is testing us. Every day, our Lord faces us with one simple question. Listen to the music in your soul.
Picking up my life, packing up the past.
Chicago. Ethel McCormick and her son, Ron, was it?
Ren.
Hmm? Speak up, boy, let the Lord hear your voice.
Ren. Ren McCormick.
Ren, interesting name. Is that short for something?
No.
There's rumors going round about it.
Oh, you remember my old tool shed right above the garage?
Wes, that place is a greasy dump.
Well, no more.
Picture this. Sky blue wallpaper with chocolate brown carpet.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
When will Mr. McCormick be joining us?
Mr. McCormick won't be joining us.
My husband and I are separated.
He ran off to find himself.
Fred, please. Bye. I've made some of my Toll House squares. Lulu, you taste one and you'll burn every recipe. Won't you join us, Mrs. McCormick? Eleanor wants to show us what heaven tastes like.
Call me Ethel, please.
Only you can call me Bob.
Save me a cookie, Ethel.
So, Ren, are you all set for school tomorrow?
Coach here helped us take care of that last week. Got them all ready for
them. Reverend, did you hear that new English teacher is planning to introduce some vulgar modern novel into our American Lit course?
Yes, Coach, Slaughterhouse 5. I received several calls.
Slaughterhouse 5? Hey, that's a good book, cover to cover. That's one bitchin' story. It's a classic.
Do you read much?
Now, Coach, maybe in another town it's a classic.
No, Uncle Wes. Every town.
Tom Sawyer is a classic.
Daddy! Excuse me. Daddy, Rusty and the girls are going out for burgers. Can I?
Tomorrow's a school day.
Daddy.
Ask your mom.
We already did, Reverend Moore. And she said okay with her if it was okay with you, says you.
10 o'clock.
10 o'clock. Great sermon, Reverend.
Thank you, Rusty.
Remember the part where they free explained what Jesus would have thought of rock and roll?
I sure do.
My mom was all like, hallelujah!
Well, it's high praise indeed. Gentlemen, let's see.
I, on the other hand, thought Daddy was never going to shut up.
Well, then, Ariel, you've got to talk to him.
Why? I mean, he doesn't even listen, and it wouldn't. Welcome to Beaumont.
Howdy.
You are cute. Wendy Jo, isn't he cute?
Uh-huh. I bet he knows he's cute, don't you think, Wendy Jo?
Uh-huh.
Where are you going?
Hold it. Take a number and get in line.
Huh? Behind who?
Church lady here. She's got that look in her eye.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, and where are you going?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Thank you. performed one night at the penitentiary.
Yeah. So, who's the new guy, Church?
He's our new classmate. A big city kid with all the charm and sophistication that comes from living in Chicago.
Should I be jealous?
I'm counting on it.
Hey, Cresman! What are you doing with the preacher's daughter?
Anything that I want.
Oh yeah, and what is she at?
Everything that she needs.
Like you know.
Miss Baccarat, she was born yesterday. With her instincts and a little sound wave. When she smiled at me, she's got angels in her eyes. But I've seen her some moves, and this girl really goes. She taught me some tricks you can't learn in books, and I'm starting to think she's a devil in disguise. The girl gets around. She knows what I like. I got what she needs. Just wait till tonight. We won't make a move. Yeah, we'll do the sun.
Hey, mister, you bumped me.
Sorry.
Don't you ever look?
I said I was sorry.
You're that new guy from Chicago, ain't you?
Perhaps.
Smart ass, huh? Listen, fella, down here, you push them and they push back. Next thing you know, you got two people pushing. Get it?
Got it. Whoa, whoa, let me ask you one more thing. They sell men's clothing where you got that hat?
Oh, what's that supposed to be? Some kind of stupid joke?
No, that's a really good joke.
That's gonna kill you!
Don't kill me! Please kill me!
Huh?
Kill me! Kill me! That's the most exciting thing I've heard since I've hit town!
Ben Park.
You are?
Willard. Willard you.
Willard, what do you guys do for fun around here? I mean, you got any movies?
Nope.
What about malls?
Nope.
What about...
Nope. And no. We got a Polarama up by the newspaper.
Wow. I really admire you. I could never do what you guys do here.
Yeah, what's that?
Nothing. I never walk when I can run. I don't believe I ever could. People try to slow me down, saying, boy, you really should. Keep back and chill, but I can't stand
my little man.
The doctor, he said, son, cannot offer you a pill, so I never found relief, and now I've got to move until I've had my fill, but I can't stand still.
Back here we walk.
Back where I come from, life's never humble. I wish I could sit there. Oh, we got the world at our feet. Life is sweet, ain't no doubt, from the sea.
You're gonna last about 5 minutes in this
town. Oh, I thought it never would end, but I lost it somehow. Would you look at me? I'm trying hard to tone it down. Gotta watch my P's and Q's. Maybe look before I leave. Then I think, hey, what's the use? Done it yet, but I can't forget how it feels when you dance and drop. Don't even stop to suggest that I stop. I never will.
Watching you guys fly in the face of authority, isn't it, Wendy Jo? Is she serious?
Serious as a heart attack.
Dancing's against the law?
Has been 5.5 years. Ever since the accident.
What accident?
The Botany Bridge accident.
What happened?
Well, there were these four kids from Belmont. Kids we all grew up with. They were driving back from a big dance center in Baylor County across the Tom River. There was a fog that night. You could see 10 feet in front of you. And who knows? Maybe they got flat. Maybe they weren't paying attention. But the road was slippery and lost control of the car. I hate this part. When they hit the brakes, the car slammed into the curb. They skidded across the bridge and right to the guardrail. They dropped 35 feet into the river. It took 15 men on a police barge 2 days to drive that car out. When Sheriff Davey posted the autopsy reports, the whole town went nuts. He claimed it was alcohol in their blood and marijuana. And that's where Reverend Moore got righteous. He blamed everything, liquor, drugs, rock and roll.
And dancing.
You got it. He convinced the town council it's all a sin, and they passed a law.
Wait a minute. Reverend Moore has that kind of power?
Reverend Moore, he's the power. He is the law.
How do you guys live?
Practice. Years of practice. It's not like Chicago. It must be so cool to live in a city where you can walk down the street and get loved by people you don't even know.
Yeah, I miss that. I thought moving to a small town would be perfect, like one big, happy family.
Let me tell you about that family. There's tongues wagging every time you make a move. There's fingers pointing every time you turn around. And there's heads shaking at the moment you pass that line. And there's eyes everywhere.
Careful what you do, someone's on to you. Careful what you do. Careful what you say,
of your role you
play every night and every day. Somebody's hiding in the lake.
Indefinitely.
Somebody, somebody.
how hard it was for me to get you that job as a bank star with you. It's only been a month and you got fired.
It's getting so that you poor little spray dance in the fall.
Lulu, don't exaggerate.
That's a hush, you're not helping us.
Pumpkin, I'm sorry, just let me have your nose with this boy. What happened, sweetie?
I don't know. I popped into the register because Will and he changed for a dollar. And Mr. Panicki goes nuclear and accused me of stealing.
That's because everything you do makes people suspicious.
Are you on drugs?
No! But why didn't you frisk me? I'm sure you had been through my room.
Red!
Apologize to your uncle.
Look, young man, I know I'm not your father.
Say that again.
Wes!
Don't say anything, Ethel.
I can't not say anything. I don't know how to do that, Wes.
Pumpkin, hush, please.
Wes, I understand that we are guests in your home.
Ethel! Right now, just don't say anything.
Never let you laugh, never leave a crown.
Never decorate your skin, don't be held to pay. If you've ever had anything too high, things might be for you never say. Somebody died not watching. Somebody died.
Thank you.
You know, part sounds great.
I like the part where Lancelot and King Arthur fight over Guinevere. That's when Mordred comes out and he's all like, I'm the king! I'm the king!
What?
You read a book?
Cliff Notes. It'll be forever.
It's even better in the book. There's all these knights jousting and storming the castle.
All we get are guys in overalls riding pickup trucks.
Hi, Willard.
How y'all doing?
Pretty good.
Yeah, all right. It's gonna be okay.
Hey, Rusty.
Hey, Willard.
We'll see ya.
Hey, Willard, that's it?
You two?
Okay.
When are you two going to have a real conversation?
Willard is not capable of real conversation.
I kind of like that new guy.
Hey, Greg. How's the new job?
Well, in 2 days, I haven't been fired yet.
You may have found your future.
Maybe. What can I get you guys?
Diet Coke. Diet Coke. I like a blueberry goat patty cheese melt with extra mayo, lettuce, tomato, onions, and fries. And Diet Coke.
Earl, what's your pleasure?
It's not on the menu.
Oh, girl!
Chuck sees you flirting with Ariel. You're gonna be a dead man.
She hardly ever remembers me.
That uniform man can look like such an idiot, so you should pick it
out. Willard, you're always looking for a fight.
Your mom says it's my nature.
Chuck doesn't want you to know about Ariel. I know she's been kissed a lot. And
she's on you like how it was locked.
Really?
Ariel like trouble when you have definitely proved to everybody in this town that you are T-R-U-B-L.
Thank you.
I don't like you making a fool out of me.
And why would you? You do such a good job of yourself.
Shut up, Rusty!
Will you be joining these ladies for dinner?
When I say meet me, what am I talking to myself?
No, you're right. Calm
down. Look how I found out there. I'm telling what to do. I know what your friends think of me. That's bullshit.
I'm the best party in this town, baby.
No street dogs will be tied up under the porch.
Let's go.
No.
Get on the bike.
No.
Excuse me?
I said no, but a part of that don't you understand?
Your two daughters saying no.
Chuck, I said no!
I believe the woman said no.
And I believe it's none of your business.
Ren, don't.
Hey, who invited this clown anyway?
Oh, sorry, we haven't been properly introduced. Ren McCormick.
Get the hell out of my face, you bitch, out of my sight!
Hey, Chuck, you looking for a fight?
Let's go right now. Come on, come on, come on!
Hey, do you have a problem here?
No, ma'am. We were just discussing the well-being of one of your valued customers.
You think that's funny?
For instance, your hall is in the handicapped parking, which is the space to be reserved for people with physical, not emotional disabilities.
Could I please kick his ass?
Willard, what Statue of Mama says, before you make a fist, you make sure it's your fight.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, this is not your fight. And don't press yourself out of curfew. Good night now. Stay calm. Don't call me. And come.
I know, ma'am. I'll turn my skates.
Listen, I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Really?
Now give me a push.
Yes, ma'am.
You are either very brave or very stupid.
Which one do you think?
I haven't made up my mind yet. Want to see something?
Don't you have a curfew?
My daddy invented it. Come on, let's go.
What? Die!
person.
You don't think much of me, do you?
Oh, no. I think more than I thought I would. Come on, I'll watch you.
That was the plan, but I I spend all of my life saying, don't do that. See everyone prays for salvation. I'm happy to give them the tools. The problem is, here's my frustration. Nobody wants to have rules. So heaven, help me with my labors. How can you expect one man to save his family and his neighbors? Heaven help me. Oh, heaven help me. If heaven can, who can?
I can't.
law too long.
Alone,
hungry,
that still never let
us get. How long we live in this shadow? This town is suffocating.
I need air.
There's only one way out.
It is
my spring. No, listen. Running away will never make you free. It doesn't matter where you go, I guarantee. Long as we hold our grounds and we cannot rebound, I'm shaking the past, making my break, taking control, and that's what it takes. Heaven helps the man who fights his fear. We can face this down right now, right here. Once you're standing on your own two feet, you will not retreat if you repeat, I'm free. Come on, everybody, try it.
I'm free.
Let the Lord hear your voices.
I'm free.
Yeah.
We're shaking our breasts, making our breaks, taking control.
Down.
Look at the moon.
you been living?
Omaha?
Yep.
No shit. Claire, what do you say we can do some tail shaking?
Hey, cowboy, she came with me.
Yeah? Well, we all make mistakes.
Oh, what's that supposed to mean?
Miller, he was just being friendly.
Oh, yeah? Hey, you got something to say?
Willard! Hey, Willard! I know who I can
hurt. All right.
Now come on, let's dance.
Oh, I'm kind of thirsty, Al. I think I'm going to get a drink.
Oh, God!
Rain, do you want a Coke or something? Sure, I'll have a Coke. You ladies want a soda?
Willard, I did not come 100 miles for a Coke.
All right, that's enough.
I want to dance.
Only got two hands. Rand, will you help me out here? Will you excuse me, Willard?
Oh, let me guess. Willard's acting weird.
So it's not just me.
Rusty, you and Willard have been acting weird since kindergarten.
But tonight is different. It's the first time we've ever left Beaumont together. Maybe we don't travel well.
It was only a car ride.
But that makes like a first date, don't you see? Oh, I should have seen the sign. The whole way here, I had to do all the talking. All he said was, My baby's in a panic.
Come on, I'll dance with you.
What's the matter with you? You seem jumpy. I mean, you're finally on a date with Rusty.
Wait a minute. This is a date? You told me to go for a drive with you. You told Ariel to me about Rusty. It's more like I'm on a date with you.
You look so handsome.
Thank you. But you stuck me in a backseat with a crazy woman who won't stop moving.
It's because she's excited to be with you.
Well, sure. Problem is.
Yeah?
Between me and you.
Uh-huh.
I can't do it. Oh, it? You can't do it?
No, sir. It's okay. It's only the first date.
Right.
Even in Chicago, we don't do it on the first date sometimes.
Really?
I swear.
Okay, well that makes me feel a whole lot better.
Good. Let's go dance.
Dance? What the hell do you think I'm talking about?
I thought when you said you couldn't do it, you meant...
Oh, well hell, any idiot can do that. I'm talking about this. I can't dance.
What?
Now come on guys, cut the guy a break.
But that ain't natural. It's like learning how to ride a bike.
Yeah, or falling off the log.
It's as easy as learning to swim.
I can't swim either.
Well, what do you say, fellas? Let's throw him in the pool.
Yeah! Darling, your boyfriend has two left feet and you had no idea.
None.
Did he ever sweep you up in his arms?
Not yet.
No, that's
not the way it is with
you,
Willard.
Well, what's
black? My baby, he don't talk sweet. He ain't got much to say.
And what's he good for?
But he loves me, loves me, loves me. I know that he loves me. Hey!
She's not here, Chuck.
Oh, Miss Moore.
Did I scare you?
Not at all. Did you tell Errol that?
Yes, Chuck. I told her every time you called.
Thanks. Well, I guess Errol's busy and all.
She and the girls went over to her new jobs. To study.
I was just there. They said Errol left hours ago.
Who is it, Lon? Mr. Cranston.
Evening, Reverend.
Isn't it a bit late, Mr. Cranston?
Right. So I'm surprised Errol's not home.
So am I. Good night, Mr. Cranston. And next time, do remember, our front door is for guests.
Yes, sir.
Where is she?
She told me she was going to Winnie Joe's. Don't bother calling. She's not there.
You knew about this?
No, I did not.
So how does it feel, Vi, now that she's lying to you as well?
I'm not saying anything until I hear her explanation.
It was bad enough when she was out with Chuck Cranston. Now she's walking around all night with that punk who's campaigning against me and the entire town council. How long can you keep defending her?
I'm not defending her. We're not on opposite sides here, are we? Or are we?
Where were you?
Rusty Magnolia.
Don't even bother.
We know you weren't doing any jokes. Now you're checking up on me? Sweetie, how are we supposed to know if you're not sick or hurt?
I'm concerned for your well-being.
Why isn't it when I'm at home you never care how I feel or what I'm doing, but the minute I walk out that door, wham! You're suddenly the concerned parent.
Josh, does it mean that?
Stop taking her side. She has to start speaking for herself.
I don't know what good that would do. You don't listen to me any more than you listen to her.
Spiritual guardian.
You used to be her friend.
I don't know what's happening. I don't know what to do anymore.
Yes, we do. Can you find it in your heart to forgive her? Can you stop and see there's part of her that's trying to obey while part of her is dying? Bye.
holy, holy. You're going to be speaking at a town council, so don't mumble. Now, do the last part of me.
Citizens of Beaumont, the size of a town is only as small as the minds of the people who live there. So think big and party on.
Lynn, we're not saying that the speech is bad. We're just saying that it ain't any good.
What should I do? I've already written it 9 times.
Well, here's the thing. You're going to be speaking to Reverend Moore and some of the stubbornest people in town.
And you've already got all of them boiling now.
Yeah, folks are picking sides.
And they're not.
Then who am I kidding? This whole thing has gotten out of hand. Maybe I should just give up.
Whoa there, little buddy. We don't need to discourage you.
After all the work we've done,
all the flyers we passed out,
everybody was climbing the wall.
You just gotta rethink your approach. Now, my mama says that.
Oh, no, no, no.
Hold it. Hold it. Everything I've ever wanted gets me through the worst. I've learned at my mama's knee. Next time I'm turned around, I turn to mama first. And you'd be wise to memorize what mama says to me. Now, mama ain't drunk yet. I'm
take that
one to work. Now, mama says don't use a toaster while standing in the shower. Now, who can argue with that? Now, mama says don't hold your breath for longer than an hour. The woman knows where it's at. And mama says, if you're a king or you're a bow, once you drive up a mountain, you can't back down. Now, Rain, you've not yet had the pleasure of meeting my mom, the big boy over here. Have now, come on and help me out here, Bill. Don't drink hot coffee, lying in bed. Don't even give it a fuck. Never eat anything. Is she a wizard?
Oh, yes.
Hey, mama said it doesn't matter if you're a queen or you're a clown. What you drive up a mountain, you can't back down. Oh, what you drive up a mountain, she's clear and concise.
She's concise.
Never said well over someone, but she's cool with me. But I say, hey, it's free advice. And what do you expect that you promise?
Mama said,
what you believe in is holy gold. I believe that she's right.
Mama said,
if you've got time for the boys and the Lord, just means you're ready to fight. And mama said, it doesn't matter if you drive a hard bargain or drive around town. Once you drive up a mountain, you can't back down.
Remember, boy, everyone's counting on your love.
Don't make me say it again.
Ren, thank God you're here. Chuck and Ariel got into a big fight and Chuck beat her up. She might have a black eye.
All right, Phyllis, come on, let's get him right now.
Phyllis, don't. I've caused enough trouble tonight. I don't need to cause any more.
Chuck's been on a tear since he found out we went dancing.
He told me I wasn't allowed to see you anymore. I told him I'd see who I like, and then he just started swinging.
Let me see your eye.
I'm just so angry at myself. I can't remember why I was with him in the first place.
You need a doctor.
I'm fine.
Need me to call your parents?
No. No, please. I just want to be alone.
Let's go, guys. Come on.
You want some company?
No. Yes.
You sure? I mean, I won't get offended or anything.
Shh.
What?
Listen!
Why?
Come on, don't miss it.
Finally coming true.
Events foster the consumption of alcohol, the use of drugs, lewd behavior.
Reverend Moore, I understand what this town has been through.
I don't think you do, son, because if you did, you would not be encouraging your classmates to reopen the wounds we've healed. Now, I don't wish to be dogmatic. If anybody here can convince me there's no danger in your raucous party plans, I will certainly reconsider my stand. But for right now, no, I cannot condemn it.
I believe a vote is in order.
All those in favor?
Wait. Isn't there some kind of discussion?
Young man, you are out of order.
This is outrageous. If you think you can get your
Roger! Order. Sit down.
I believe Mr. McCormick has a right to be heard.
All right!
not a crime.
Yeah.
Ever since the dawn of time, if anything, anybody had the right to howl at the moon and to move all night. When folks were tribal, back before the Bible, their lives danced when the crops came in. Well, they pulled all the stops when the earth would spin, or maybe
what?
They had a battle to win. So they go thumping on a tree trunk. Moving to the free funk.
Yeah!
And just like that,
and it grabs it flat,
there'd be hand slapping, toes tapping, feet flapping, dogs yapping, hey! Cause you told us that was happening. Dancing with it every time they had a chance. Whatever the season or circumstance, they found a reason to throw a party in the pants and they dance.
Wow, they were dance.
Yeah, dance.
Dance, they were dance.
Oh, dance.
Dance, they were dance.
Yeah, dance.
Dance, they were dance.
We're cool. Never heard about Adam and Abraham. You remember this guy from the book of Samuel. David, you know King David?
David.
He made a science out of knocking out giants. Didn't like math or geography. Check this out. The choreography.
Devil ran. There's a law. Now what were you saying to Reverend Shaw?
Right here in black and white. As he was leaping and dancing with all of his might.
Leaping and dancing.
In front of his lord. But David wasn't doing it for some reward. It might sound odd, but David thought it brought him closer to God, so he would dance.
Hallelujah.
Every time he had the chance, whatever the season or circumstance, he found a reason to throw a party and he danced.
My day!
He dance doesn't always make you do. Ask each book in the book of Ecclesiastes.
Right.
There's a time to laugh, a time to weep. There's a time to plant, a time to reap, and there's a time to dance. He says right here,
right here.
And he'll dance. The Bible tells me so. What have I got to fear? We only wanted to kick up our heels, and I bet you every one of you knows how that feels. I bet you do.
They do.
I bet you do.
They don't, but we know they do.
People been dancing since God knows when. That's the way it should be. Again, so let's dance. Every time we get a chance, whatever the season or circumstance, you find a reason, throw a party in your pants. Let's dance. Amen. Whatever the season or reason is pleasing to dance. He's a man of God.
He's a man. And
Damn! That pisses me off!
Good. Now listen. Reverend Moore said he would only reconsider if somebody convinced him there was no danger in your ruckus party plans.
Ruckus party plans? Do you believe this? What am I gonna do?
Go talk to him. Make him reconsider.
Now?
Yes, now. If you don't, you're never gonna make peace with this town.
What do I say?
Beats me. All I know is that Shaw Moore is real smart. He's real stubborn. But so are you. I'd love to stay and watch, but I have to go home and hose down your Aunt Lulu and Uncle Wes.
Love you, Mom.
You have no choice. Now go.
Congratulations. Can I help you, Mr. McCormick? Judging by the look on your face, I could ask you the same thing. This wasn't a pleasant evening for any of us. By the way, did you tell the town council how to vote?
What?
I mean, did you know what they were going to say before they came in?
Brendan, you're too young to understand the dangers that exist in the world.
Maybe. But you didn't answer my question.
Ren, this is more than a question of dance.
It is, isn't it? I mean, for you and for me. Reverend, I didn't just want to throw a party.
What did you think you were doing then?
When I moved here, I felt like my life was over. I felt like if I could make a difference, if I could change something. I'm sorry, Reverend. I guess I just picked the wrong fight.
And you will finally drop this.
Hey, the votes are in. That's been...
Yes, it has. Now, if you will excuse me.
One more thing. Does it make things better? I mean, really?
You don't stop, do you?
I know about your son.
You know nothing about my son.
You're right. All I know is that there was a car crash and doesn't make any sense.
And I don't ask for it to make sense. I believe in the will of God.
But if you miss your son as much as I miss my dad, it's gotta hurt. I try to bring him back 100 times a day, but I just can't, you know? And I understand. And so does Ariel. Probably better than anybody.
Don't speak to me about my daughter.
Why do you think she does the things she does? Just to scare you? She's trying to get your attention.
Mr. McCormick, I wish to end this discussion. I believe we've said all that needs to be said.
No! Listen! If you don't start listening to Ariel, you're gonna lose her. Maybe not like you lost Bobby, but you're gonna lose her.
Mr. McCormick, I wish to be alone.
Sir, you already are.
Get out of here! Get out of here, you! Get out! Oh yes, he has all the answers. He's gonna set me straight. How can he presume to know what I've been through? He hasn't got a clue. But how can anyone, unless they've had a son? As perfect as a child could be, the best of all the best in me, my brush with immortality, I hid. For 16 winters and 15 springs, I had a son, and still it stings when I remember all the things we did, me and my kid.
I confess, I didn't always have the answers. I didn't always know which way was true. Nevertheless, I always try to lead with love. That's all that any father can do. As the years went by, we had our differences. Then, who doesn't? Even if the friendship wasn't all it was before, we shared a lot. And who'd have thought that so much joy could finish in a blink? Who ever stops to think? And in that final moment, who knows what went wrong? The questions come too late and linger far too long. And I confess, I don't always have the answers. I don't always know which way is true. Nevertheless, I always try to lead with love. That's all that any father can do. What do I do? This boy comes to me, this fatherless child. I scoff at his pain and I send him away. My daughter speaks up and I shout her down. I won't hear a word of what she has to say. My wife reaches out and I turn my back. I send her to bed without even a kiss. Can my God forgive the things I have done while I try forgetting how much I'm still missing my son? I'm tired of nothing but none. Maybe the time has come to finally let the world in. But how do I begin? Give me strength and maybe then I can reach my fellow men, so we all may rise again. Last night, something happened to me that hasn't happened in a very long time. I changed my mind. It was a terrifying moment, but it was exhilarating. And this morning, I want to offer you all the same opportunity. Our senior class has asked permission to throw a dance. And right now, I think that's a good idea. You see, as your minister, I should be helping you all to find the joy in your life. And I haven't been doing that. We have, all of us, and I include myself in that number, we've been holding on to a memory that's brought us nothing but pain. Memories brought us sorrow, it has provoked fear, it has caused suspicion. Have we forgotten that the highest form of love is faith? If we don't start trusting our children, how will they ever learn to become trustworthy? I confess, I don't always have the answers. I don't always know which way is true. Nevertheless, I always try to lead with love. Please join me in asking our Lord to guide and protect our children.
Here's the deal. I was gonna put a sheet over the front seat of the truck. That way everyone ended up smelling like a dog. Daddy's suit kind of fits me. I was thinking I could roll up a pant leg with a little bit of duct tape.
I love where this is going.
And Mama said she'd whip up one of them croissant things.
A corsage?
Yeah, one of them.
You're painting a picture for me, aren't you? I see rusty truck that smells bad, a taped up brown suit, and me wearing a corsage made out of God knows what.
What do you think?
Is there a dance in there someplace?
You want
to? Willard, I would love to. Don't even think about it! Shaw, you were wonderful this morning.
Really?
Yes. You reminded me of how much I missed you. Us.
You're beautiful.
Thank you.